In this video, we are going to learn how to implement Google Mobile interstitial ads into our Flutter application. Implementing interstitial ads are very easy and also they play an important role in generating a good revenue. So if you are new to the channel, please subscribe and press that bell icon so you will be notified whenever a new video is uploaded. So let's begin. So we have opened a project in our Visual Studio Code, that is Flutter Ads, that we also used in our last video, that was Flutter Banner Ads. So if you don't know how to set up your project for Google Mobile Ads, you must watch that video, because in that video we did all the setup and then displayed our banner ad. So in this video we are going to display interstitial ad. For that, in the lib folder and home.dot, I have created a button, and this button navigates us to interstitial ad page, and when we open it we see all this code. So this is interstitial ad page, that is also a stateful widget, and here we are returning a scaffold with an app bar and a body. So to implement interstitial ads we have to create some objects and variables for that. So I'll create interstitial ad and name it interstitial ad, and now we have to initialize it. But as we did in our banner ad, we won't initialize it here. So I will add let, and after that we have to create a flag. So bool is add loaded, so it will be false by default. And after that we have to initialize our interstitial ad. For that we are going to create a method init interstitial ad, and here in this we have to initialize our interstitial ad, not like banner ad but using interstitial ad dot load property, and here we have to provide all these three things. So first we have to add the ad unit ID, which we don't have till yet, so we'll keep it empty. And now we have to pass our request. So just like banner ad, we'll pass a ad request here. So after that we have to pass add load callback methods. So here interstitial add load callbacks, and here we have to provide these two methods, when add is loaded and when add is failed to load. When add is loaded we have to initialize our interstitial add. So here interstitial add will be equal to add. So now our add will be initialized, and if it fails to load, so let's just use a set state and change this is add loaded to true. And if our ad is failed to load, then what to do? Do something. Interstitial ad dot dispose so that it will be removed from the memory and your application won't cause any lagging issue. So after the ad is loaded we are ready to display. So this is our app, this is our home page, and go to next page, and now here it is our interstitial ad, the which we are working on. So now we have to display our interstitial ad, which is very important. So we have to display our interstitial ad between intervals, or you can say somewhere. Like if you are doing some work here and you are editing pictures, so when editing you don't have to display any ad. It will cause bad user experience and the user won't use your application that much. So when the user is done editing, then if he clicks on the save button you can display your ad there, or if he clicks back you can display your ad. Let's take another example, that if a user is playing a game and he is going through a level, don't show any interstitial ad while he is playing. When he is done completing that level and he clicks next, then you can display your interstitial ad. This way your account won't be banned for false activity or false clicking. So it's very important to keep this in mind. So let's say user is doing some work and after that he clicks this task completed button, and it can be a save, it can be export, it can be cancel, anything. So here we have to check if our ad is loaded, then only we display our ad. For that we have to show interstitial@.show. Now let's go to our init state method. So init state, and here we have to initialize our init interstitial add, so that whenever our this page is executed, init state method will be executed and this method will load our add, or if it fails to load, it will dispose our add. Now the only thing we have to do here is add our unit ID. For that we have to go to our website, that is apps.admob.com, and here in the app section, the app we created last time, so let's click it. And after that we have to go to add units. We added this banner add last time, so here let's create another one. And now we are talking about this interstitial add. Here select this, and now you have to type the name of your add, so interstitial android. So you can also customize like banner add, and after that create add unit. So here we got our app ID and add unit ID. We know where to place our app ID, and this is our real unit ID. So we don't use real add IDs during development phase, so we have to use some dummy. For that we have to go to this interstitial implementation guide and scroll a bit, and here we'll get our dummy ID. Just copy it and close this file, and now come here and paste this here, or you can create another variable. So let's create add unit and paste this and say test ID, and now you can simply use your variable here. Save and okay. So let's just go back and go back to our next page to see. Okay, so our ad must be loaded now. So let's click this task completed button. So here is our interstitial ad, and we have successfully implemented it. Let's just close it. Now comes the important part. What we want to do after closing this ad, because we don't want to display the user the same page he was on before that ad was loaded. For that, after the ad is loaded, we have to use full screen callbacks method. So here whenever ad is loaded, we can say interstitial ad dot full screen content callback is equal to full screen content callback, and here we can use all these methods, that whenever ad is clicked, or when ad is dismissed, when ad failed to load, when ad impression. So when ad is dismissed, what we want to do that time, you can say increase the level, or you can save the user's file according to your need. So whatever you want to do here, just simply dispose your ad, and after that do whatever you want. And after that we have to use another method. So whenever our ad is failed to load full screen content, we must dispose our ad so that it won't cause any lagging issue. Let me just show you something, that whenever ad is dismissed, let's print ad is dismissed. Use a set state method here to set your is ad loaded to false again, and the same thing goes here also. Okay, so let's go back and come back to our interstitial ad. So our ad request will be sent, and when our ad request is sent, let's just simply click this task completed button, and here it is our ad. So let me just clear this thing, and after dismissing this ad, let me just see, you can see the ad is dismissed. So when the user dismissed that, you can perform whatever you want. So I hope you found this video helpful. See you in the next one. Till that, Allah Hafiz.